Here's how you want to organize your math binder for 7th grade with Mr. Rudisill. Somewhere on the front cover you want to put the word math and your name. Could just be your last name if you like, so it's easy to identify. Inside you want to keep the organizational paper. If you don't have a pocket over here, you can just put in the three rings, put it right on top. Since mine has a pocket, I will keep it on the side. You want to have your point record sheet as the first sheet. When you turn the point record sheet, you get to your class syllabus. Turn the syllabus, you get to the Do Now paper. And then you're going to get to your formula sheet, also known as a reference sheet for grade 7 for PSSAs. That should be in a plastic protector. Next, you'll see your notes. You're going to have your note divider that you created. And then you'll have your notes section. Now, there's two ways you can organize your notes section. You could have it in chronological order. The student learning map will always be first, and then any notes after that. Or, which I prefer to do, I do it the exact opposite. I put my newest stuff on top. And a lot of students like to do that. So the next set of notes you get, you put it on top. So you're actually working backwards. Then you turn to your assignment section. In the assignment section, the very top paper will be the most recent assignment. Practice, some people call it homework. And then after your assignment section or homework section would be your PSSA test prep section. And right now we don't have anything in there. And that's how you want to organize your math binder for this year. So this binder organization paper just lists the things I just went over. What should be in order, point record sheet first, then the syllabus, then the Do Now page and formula sheet in the page protector, then your notes section with your notes in, your assignments section with your assignments and homework in, and then the PSSA section.